well if we do this, that's a good thing. Both hands and going down one leg. And again, you can go down as far as feels great for you, but don't go too far that feels uncomfortable. So you're just feeling the skin floating, and then come up that same leg when you're ready. It's a bit like saying hello legs, which we may have not done today. So hello legs.
Hello legs. 你好呀，我的腿。
Show your expressions, communicate. And then finally, this is the skin, the muscle, and then this is finally going to be the bones. So you just gently take a fist, and really gently, you're just going to gently kind of knock the bones. Almost like, for me, it feels like the most ancient layer, so the deepest one. So you're just gently knocking. Then you might even notice the sound change. And of course, you're very, as we're in this space and we're doing this, you can go, that's not good. Good, go down the body. massage. And then down the bed, finding the bones there. Eventually and finally onto the bones of your face. Great. So we've done skin, muscle, and bones. And just let that go. So we've done our three layers. The next thing we're going to do, which most people do already, is just do a little shake. And just be really gentle with the knees. And again, your shake could be like this, yours could be very small. Almost like whatever you don't need, you just drop something. And all we're going to do very simply is take a nice easy breath through the nose, in the nose, and then just set out a kind of nice low sound. It's just like, last thing we're going to do, just take the arms, just do a few circles like this with the arms. Hopefully you've got some of that bit. You just feel like you're searching around. So you can kind of feel the space around you a little bit. Especially above us. Loads of space above us. When you're ready, you're just going to stay up at the top like this, feeling like kind of nice, not without shoulders up by your ears, but just drop. And then turn your palms to face forward wherever your head is. And just notice here how you feel, like almost like a place where you check in with your heart, what this position makes you feel like. To me, it feels like a very universal position, which means men are different. And then take the arms out to the side, arms still facing forward. You just notice what this position is. What you can come up with. Maybe it's just that your arms are out, that's what I mean. And then taking the arms down to the low. And then just take an inhale through the nose. And on the exhale, just lower the arms. Thank you.
And while you're here, just really start to notice how the breath's coming into the body, how it's falling in. Not trying to change it, just becoming aware of it. Coming into the chest, into the belly, into the back. Sounds it wants to write onto those pages. skin, your barrier between your body and the rest of the space. Gathering a sense of that energy that we went into when we were kind of touching the outsides, lathering the outsides, our book covers. And just sensing the sounds and the stories that this body wants to make, that this body has made and this body is yet to make. Your book, your body, your book body inside this beautiful space. How high the ceilings are, how dense the air is. And start to hear the sounds of the room. Expand your listening out to the other books inside this space. All of their stories, all of their words, all of their pictures, their potential. And then out into the sounds outside this space, and the beauty of this big vast museum. All of the different energies, stories going on inside these spaces. And sense what it feels like to be here in this body, in this space, amongst all these other spaces. And then slowly gathering all of that back into this room, back through all of the other books, back towards your own book cover, your skin, your barrier, and back into your pages, into another new blank page.
Focus, the beautiful kind of presence, that listening, it's like really tangible. And in your own time, you're just going to slowly get up from your seats in your own time. And I'm just going to allow you, you can just take the space in, so you can walk kind of, I'd say, quite slowly around the space. Feel like you can go anywhere. Remember, you can't touch all of any of the books and things, but weave yourself, the chairs will be in different places, so just weave yourself around. But take in that space, and as you do, just notice if your body is inclined to respond in any way to the space. Like, you may notice that you want to see, like, try out a gesture that might feel like you and the space kind of talking to each other a little bit, or something about the height of the space. Like, I'm not giving you suggestions, but just that sense of what my body might want to try out. Again, don't feel like you have to search for anything, because just looking around is enough. But it's just about feeling like that idea that we're in this space and we have permission to use our bodies in slightly different way. And just notice what that might make you want to kind of restore. So in your own time, taking care as you come up, just start to get to your feet and then feel that you can just travel about the space a little bit. And just notice if you want any part of the body, wants to go under the table, over the thing. That's it, great. Does it make you want to move? Where do you find yourself? What part of this kind of calling to you? Yeah, what can you touch? Great.
corridor. You might want to have a moment of something quite fast. So different tempos, feeling like we can disrupt the air.
So now I'm going to start with a tone, and I want everybody to just join in, make a bass of some kind of sound together, whatever that is to you, and then slowly you can start exploring the sound of your book. So just if some sound of your cover or the library or anything wants to just pop out of you over the top of this bass that we're creating together, just go for it. We're just going to see what happens. We're going to start quite small, and then we can build up, and we just see where it goes. So, yeah, I won't say anything more. Let's just see what happens. So if I start with like a... Keep going. And if that feels comfortable just to stay there the whole time, you can do that as well. I encourage you to get as close as possible. Start to see what comes out. on the ground if it's comfy. Close enough so you'll almost touch it. So, if this is comfortable for you, you can place a hand on, can I, may I do this? On the person next to your shoulders.
Yeah,
sure. And if that's not, that's cool. If it's not your jam, it's cool. Or it could be like, I mean, you know, somewhere, I mean, if you know the person next to you, put your hand on it, whatever. Yeah. And it can, if it's weird to have both hands as well, just realise that might make people like, ah. Just to have one, it's cool. So there's some sense of people being connected, but if it stresses out your chest in any way, just have one hand. Yeah, great. So feeling, as you feel this as well, just that hurt, you might even be aware of the heat underneath your hand that's generated from the person you're touching. So that person is that aliveness of that person. So just feel that for a second. And I'm imagining that for most people, this is a complete stranger. So just being aware of that as well, of that you can feel this person's heat, this person's life force, and you may have not even looked at them, you probably won't know their name, but how kind of immediate is that sense of connection? And sometimes we don't need words or explanations. And if your arms get tired, you can always just bring them down and change the place where they are, of course. Then we're going to gift each other some hum vibrations. So just when you're ready, taking a couple of deep breaths in and out. Breathing it out, just inhale. And this time we're going to breathe into a hum.
Have got contact with somebody else's body, just before you kind of remove your hand, just almost give them a tiny, very gentle kind of squeeze and let them know you're about to remove your hand.
Thank you so much.
feel like somebody said in the last one at the end of this, they were like, feels like I know people. You know that feeling where you go, and there hasn't been
communication.
Yeah, right. There hasn't been a lot of stuff. There's just been, like, I can really see your eyes now. And the same applies to me and Sean in that sense of, you know, that trepidation when there's a group of new people, and actually that's what happens when you move and make sound together. Something comes into the collective and drops, and it's just, it's not magic, it's human. It's so human. Right, of course. And it's weirdly, it's almost like we all know that somewhere. It's kind of our...
Thank you so much for your spending your incredible Friday nights in this
place. Thank you.
Great. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
If anybody wants to follow us, our information is available. And we're doing a performance at the Barbican, and it's public performances at the Barbican on the summer solstice on the 24th. It's the Wicker Man. Have a beautiful evening. Enjoy the magic of this incredible space, and thank you so much for all of the energy you brought into here. I feel so blessed. Awesome! Thank you. Yeah. Cool.